Hi, in this video I'm going to review the Noco Genius Boost HD Jump Starter Battery Pack. This is one of their heavier duty units. It's rated for 8-liter gas engines or 6-liter diesel engines. On the front of the box, you've got some specs. On the side panel shows 2 amp USB out, 2 amp micro USB in, 12 volt 3 amp in, and 12 volt 15 amp out, which is plenty for running things like other 12 volt accessories. It's got the stuff that's inside the box. On the back, it shows some other specs. This picture showing this 12 volt outlet, this 12 volt USB out going directly into your cell phone is a little bit misleading, and I'll show you why once we get into the box. It also has a 400 lumen LED flashlight with a lot of different modes. I'll show you those in a second. So let's open the box. This isn't a true unboxing because I've actually been using this unit for a couple of months now to test it, and I just want to show you what's inside. Got the user manual. Who reads those? Caution: fully charged before use. Okay. Got the unit itself, well packed, and the accessory box. Inside the accessory box, you have this 12 volt adapter cable, micro USB cable, female 12 volt outlet, male 12 volt outlet adapter, and you also have a carrying case. So this can help you keep all this stuff in one place without losing it, which is kind of nice. Let's talk about the unit itself. So first, how do you charge it? To charge it, there's two methods, a slow method and a fast method. The slow method is to use this micro USB cable. Yeah, it's always the reverse one. That you can plug into your phone charger outlet, and it would go through the in on this side port. The faster way is to use this 12 volt adapter cable. So the way this works is each end has two ends, and you kind of have to figure out which one fits in what. And you would plug one end into your in 12 volt and your other end into your 12 volt outlet on your car while you're driving down the street or something. That's a fast way. While I'm here, let's talk about the out ports. So the outlet port is a 12 volt outlet port where you can charge your 12 volt accessories. I've been testing this unit and use it frequently with a tire inflator. So the way this works is you would plug your 12 volt tire inflator into this 12 volt outlet while the unit is powered on, and I find that the battery pack is doing a really good job with getting plenty of uses out of it, so battery life is nice and long. Now let's go to that picture that I found was a little bit misleading on the box. So my phone has a micro USB connection. So on the box it shows you plugging your phone directly into here. It won't work because your phone senses there's something different about the amps or the volts, and as a result it won't charge. The way I've been getting around that is, let's say you want to charge your phone or your GoPro or music player or whatever. In those cases, what I do is I take this 12 volt outlet, use a car adapter for the 12 volt system, and then I plug my micro USB cable into that. So this is how I get around any smart circuitry on the phone, preventing it from charging. So if your phone won't charge directly off of this USB outlet, you can always do this method. Let's look around the box, this unit, and look at this some more. The plastic quality is actually pretty good. It's got these clamps clamped onto these dummy posts. When you go to use the unit, you'll find that this minus on the negative terminal and this plus on the positive terminal are really helpful. So when you go to use this unit, you know, the clamps open nice and wide like this. Clamp these onto the metal terminal, wiggle them around a little bit just to make sure you have a good connection. And when you connect them, connect minus to minus and plus to plus. Your battery might have plastic covers over the battery terminals. So make sure you remove any plastic covers on the battery terminals before you clamp these on, wiggle them a little bit, and then turn the unit on. The nice thing about the Noco Genius Boost HD is that it has the smart circuitry. So even if you turn the unit on while putting the clamps on, it won't spark. I can go like this with the unit on and nothing happens. And if you reverse the polarity on these cables, let's say you put them, you know, on the wrong terminal, it also won't do anything. It won't blow out or damage anything on the car. Now, there is a way to override that. So let's say your battery voltage is below 2 volts and it's just really dead, or for whatever reason you want to override the smart circuitry. You can press and hold this red exclamation point button, and it will start to look like this. This means it's ready to charge. So if I was to touch these clamps together, I'm not going to do that, they would spark right now. When it looks like that, your car is ready to jump start. It also has this button here for the lights. So it's got 3 different modes of intensity. It also has this flashing light and also has a sequence flasher, so left and right flashing. So that's my review of the Genius Boost HD GB70. As a disclaimer, they did send me this unit for review, but I have not received any other compensation otherwise. And all in all, it's a good unit. Heavy duty plastic, feels good quality. It's a little bit more expensive, but you know, you get what you pay for. And battery life so far looks good. I've only tested this for a couple of months with my tire inflator, but the battery, according to this gauge, doesn't go down very much. I'm sure that like any other battery in cold weather, the performance is not going to be as good, but this is small enough that you can put it in your trunk. So whenever you have the need for it, you can pull it out of this nice carrying case and you'll be good to go. So thanks for watching. Check out my YouTube channel for other useful diesel and car videos, and subscribe if you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.